WWE SmackDown was awesome, the two worsts mentioned in the video are important, but let that not detract from the fact that this was a great show. It also goes to show that when WWE tries, they can pull off milestone events. What did you think of WWE SmackDown at Madison Square Garden this week? Do you think it was the best show of the week when you compare it to NXT, Raw, Impact Wrestling, Dynamite and Rampage? Feel free to share your thoughts with us in the comments section below. Number 3, Best and Worst. Was the final WWE SmackDown segment a spoiler? Okay, make no mistake about it. This was one of the highlights of WWE SmackDown, and it is absolutely great to see this avatar return again. But then again, consider the facts as presented here. We know that Brock Lesnar vs. Roman Reigns is happening at some point down the line, so is that a spoiler that the Demon King will be beaten? Also, as good as the moment was, Michael Cole did not seem surprised at all to see the Demon King. It was almost like he watched one of our videos and checked out the rumor that broke regarding his return. McAfee, on the other hand, had an enthusiasm which was infectious. Number 2, Best, two veterans tear it up on WWE SmackDown in an incredible match. The WWE SmackDown match between Edge and Seth Rollins may have been even better than their SummerSlam clash. Yes, the wrestling was great, but the expressions on the faces of both men made the match. There's likely to be a rubber match between these two veterans at some point down the line. Yes, the hospitalization angle is overdone in wrestling, but the way that it was done just added a somber touch to WWE SmackDown. Number 2, Worst, the unfortunate fall of the Intercontinental Championship. Sure, the multi-man tag team match on WWE SmackDown was just a device to bring in NBA star Trae Young to pop a rating. Did the match have to include the Intercontinental Champion though, who was made to look like a nobody? The Raw crowd was upset at Jeff Hardy being used in the 24/7 championship segment, but this is just as bad. It's weird to tell one of your champions that there are no plans for him in this manner. Number 1, Best, the first few WWE SmackDown moments. WWE SmackDown had a red-hot start this week thanks to Brock Lesnar, Roman Reigns, The Usos, and Paul Heyman. The setup at SummerSlam was great, but nobody would have predicted that the aftermath would be this good. When Brock Lesnar speaks, he makes sure that the little he says is absolutely impactful. The crowd at WWE SmackDown hung onto every word, and Paul Heyman deserves special credit for telling a great story with his amazing expressions. Also, how good is his chemistry with Kayla Braxton in backstage segments? Number 1, Worst, still no women's matches. Sure, the WWE SmackDown women's roster was booked in a contract signing segment and also a backstage skit with Paul Heyman, but nothing else. It doesn't exactly spell confidence when one of the biggest shows of the year has no women's matches at all. That said, there was definitely a lot more good than bad on WWE SmackDown this week. Why do you think Raw cannot put on shows of this caliber when SmackDown can? Seth Rollins recently reacted to the news of Olympic gold medalist Gable Steveson signing with WWE, but in doing so, he might have irked latest AEW signings Bryan Danielson, FKA Daniel Bryan, and CM Punk. The WWE SmackDown superstar retweeted the original tweet by WWE and wrote the following: "Best wrestler in the world coming to the best wrestling company in the world, love to see it, Gable Steveson is WWE," tweeted Rollins. While Rollins' words might look like harmless enthusiasm over the news of Gable Steveson coming to WWE, upon further inspection it can be said that the Messiah's tweet has a hidden meaning. Rollins' tweet about the best wrestler in the world could refer to Steveson, but it is also the nickname of former WWE star Bryan Danielson. Not only that, but Danielson's colleague CM Punk, who made his in-ring return at AEW All Out after 7 years away, is also famously called the best in the world. Seth Rollins also spiced things up by referring to WWE as the best wrestling company in the world. It goes without saying that WWE has recently come under fire from fans as the overall quality of their shows have been deteriorating. While Seth Rollins is undoubtedly one of the best professional wrestlers of the current era and a huge name in WWE, the four-time world champion is not without his fair share of controversies. Not long ago, Rollins came under fire for an unsavory tweet made towards NJPW's Will Ospreay. Rollins, however, later admitted his mistake and apologized to Ospreay. While it remains to be seen if either Bryan Danielson, CM Punk or someone from AEW will respond to Rollins, the tweet has already caused dissension among fans of both companies on Twitter. What do you make of Seth Rollins' tweet? Do you think it is harmless banter or something serious? Leave your thoughts in the comments section below. Universal Champion Roman Reigns finally responded to Brock Lesnar's challenge on this week's episode of Friday Night SmackDown. Airing from Madison Square Garden, SmackDown kicked off with an incredible segment. The Bloodline made their way to the ring first and Roman Reigns asked the MSG crowd to acknowledge him. This prompted Brock Lesnar to come out and confront the Tribal Chief. The Beast Incarnate threatened Paul Heyman while asking him to accept his challenge to face Roman Reigns for the Universal title. Just when he was about to deliver an F5 to Heyman, Reigns made the save. following the main event of SmackDown, Roman Reigns took the mic. The Universal Champion seemingly accepted Lesnar's challenge, claiming that he will face him after Finn Balor. The show went off the air with the return of the demon Finn Balor, who confronted Roman Reigns. WWE has already announced Roman Reigns will defend his Universal Championship against Finn Balor at the upcoming Extreme Rules pay-per-view later this month. After Reigns' comments tonight, we might see him facing Brock Lesnar at WWE Crown Jewel 2021, which will take place in Saudi Arabia on October 21. WWE is doing a great job booking this feud between the two heavyweights. Paul Heyman's allegiance is also on the line as we don't know whose side Heyman will take. However, Roman Reigns has another huge challenge before Lesnar. The demon Finn Balor is undefeated on the main roster and could be a serious threat to the Tribal Chief's reign. Comment down and let us know your thoughts on tonight's segment between Brock Lesnar and Roman Reigns and the return of the demon Finn Balor. Paul Heyman is teasing an interesting scenario involving Roman Reigns and Brock Lesnar in the near future. Heyman had a chat with the New York Post and was asked about working with Brock Lesnar in the past as a full-fledged heel. The New York native was then asked about Lesnar's views on portraying the role of a face. Heyman presented an interesting scenario in response to the question, teasing that Brock Lesnar could target a different champion than Roman Reigns. Heyman hinted that in such a case, he could manage both megastars at the same time. I don't know if we end up in a situation where Brock Lesnar can't go after a different championship other than Roman Reigns, and he can have his advocate and Roman Reigns can have his special counsel. There's a lot of decisions to be made, and there's a lot of scenarios that can play out, and I dare suggest anyone who thinks that they have this figured out doesn't have a clue as to the twists and turns that could and will come in the near future, said Heyman. From the very beginning of Brock Lesnar's WWE run, Paul Heyman has been by his side. Heyman has acted as Lesnar's mouthpiece for the better part of his WWE career, and has consistently delivered incredible performances. The 55-year-old is still exceptional in his current role. Aligning Reigns with Heyman has been one of the best decisions WWE has taken in recent memory. Heyman's tease is certainly something to think about. If Lesnar ends up gunning for the WWE title and moving to Raw, there's no reason Heyman can't manage both him and Reigns at the same time. What do you think of Heyman's tease? Would you prefer to see Brock Lesnar and Roman Reigns on separate brands with Heyman managing both WWE superstars?